Today I'd like to talk about how intellectual rigging has completely distorted the perception of the right-wing discourse amongst the urban Indian youth. I describe intellectual rigging as that purposeful distortion of an ideology, that collaborative effort between the media, academia, selected social political platforms, other vested interests, to promote one ideology, to promote one thought under the guise of it being liberal. And as we all know, the word liberal is very attractive to the young person. But right at the outset, let me tell you that I personally believe that all these political labels, right-wing versus the left-wing, in the last few generations have metamorphosed into absolutely nothing but divisive vituperations. Across the world, they have been used to propagate vested interests. And in India, for some reason, we have adopted these Western ideologies without any deeper understanding to what they truly represent to us, leading to an extremely deep contentious divide within the Indian political discourse. For instance, the right-wing ideology, according to Western and theoretical understanding of the ideology, maybe it's seen as associated to Christian conservative values, or maybe to the church, or maybe to free markets. But in India, amongst the urban Indian youth, it is seen as a regressive ideology. It is seen as an ideology that is trying to assert a majoritarian Hindu, as well as maybe an extreme traditionalist agenda. But of course, they look at it like this because they look at it from a distorted perception. They look at it from a Western lens. They forget that what they dismiss as majoritarian Hindu is egalitarian in nature. And I wanted to discuss a little bit about how this sort of distorted perception of the right-wing ideology that has been systematically created has also played a huge role in the anti-CA riots, but maybe we'll leave that to the discussions. But I think all of you will agree with me that nothing contributes more to the rancor of the Indian political discourse than this sort of indiscriminate use of these political labels as partisan epithets, as we have seen recently. And since the change of our political power centers in 2014, we have truly seen these political labels and the distorted perceptions of these political labels really come into play. Now, let me give you a personal example. I'd like to share this with you today. It is very close to my heart, and it is how systematically intellectual rigging is carried out within the academia. Many years ago, when I was studying abroad, I decided to apply to one of the finest institutions of liberal education. This institution was based on freedom of expression. It was based on liberal thought. It had huge funding to study the Orient. So I thought, what would be a better place than this to study the development of the Hindutva amongst the millennials? Of course, I was very naive and trusting, but I think a lot of people at that age are. I applied, I got in. And very soon I realized that my supervisors wanted me to look at this subject from the same point of view that they looked at it from, which was heavily tainted with the colonial hangover. I refused to do that. Then they suggested I must look at it from a minority perspective, presumably for academic balance. I couldn't do that. It didn't make sense to me. So finally they said, you know, maybe you should resist from using books that were either published in India by Indian publishing houses or by seemingly Hindu ideologues or by maybe what they saw as pro-India writers. When that didn't work out, they simply asked me to change the subject. I was unwilling to do that. And that pretty much brought me to a very abrupt end at this wonderful center of liberal education. Of course, no, England. And obviously, you know, I was taken by surprise because to me, an institution and academicians that promoted themselves as liberal, this was not liberal, this was radical and extreme. And that's when it struck me that the word liberal in itself has become irrevocably associated to the authoritarian mindset of the identitarian left. When I came back to India, intellectual rigging was rampant here as well. Unfortunately for us, we had been left with this huge burden of white worshipping brown sahibs who the colonialists had left us with and who had dominated our media, our academia, our political, social platforms for generations. And these brown sahibs insisted on confronting opposing ideas, not in the tradition, in the Indian tradition of, let's say, samvad, vivad, or purva paksh, you know, but in intimidation. They silenced their detractors with alienation and intimidation, just like their predecessors, the colonialists. To conclude, Praful, I'd like to say that I believe that, you know, all this intellectual rigging that has been systematically going on in this country for ages, and not just in academia, but in certain sections of the media and, you know, many other areas of career, our career choices. If we are truly, truly serious in bringing a balance back to our Indian political discourse, then we need to, as individuals and as true progressives of this society, reassert the centrality of open debate as a cornerstone of our society. And I think it is only then that we will be able to bring back the right discourse as we see it, truly from an Indian perspective. Thank you.